are you guys doing today? So, of course, we're on the moon Monria and the universe Entropia. And we're going to be collecting the daily manufacturer 500 mission again. This will be episode 25 of doing so. If you don't know, Monria has a mission where every day you can make 500 successful crafts. And you don't turn it into them, so you can, it's actually very advantageous. You're making real runs. And you receive 75 PEC in engineering skill. So we're trying to unlock the skill manufacturing methodology, which is the item unlocked secret skill for 40th level. And so equipment methodology, it goes for your subcomponents and stuff like that. The manufacturing methodology will get at level 40, in which our closest one right now is this projectile launcher engineering. Now, it is 39.3537. I'm gaining about 1 to 2% per day in doing this. As you can see, we're fully qualified, and this guy is a 45th level mechanical engineer. And so, he is able to actually make this run. I'm going to be using a EP2 like I've done with this entire series. We're getting 300 PED in nanocubes. I'm going to pre-scan some people. We know Papa scores, but maybe you guys don't. Hold on. There's Papa scores. Agility and intelligence, obviously working on crafting right now. Robber is a beast, has been here for days. Also, Red Hot, I don't think I've seen your skills before. Boom. Look at that. Right. I think this guy had beast skills too. Yeah, look at that. Is that not beast? 115 agility. Oh, and he is a supreme master laser dude. Great master sniper. Don't mess with him. He'll snipe you. Just gonna say that. That's my belief. Okay, so I'm gonna click this to this. That'll allow you to see whatever skills I gain and the overall PED value of what we get. As you can see, this is a 100% blueprint, EP2. Click that over like that. Now, over here, you're gonna be able to. Let me make sure my thing's in the right place. Boom. You'll be able to see the stuff. Well, basically, I'll click it every little bit. We'll check and we'll see where the overall progress is on that EP stuff. I'll have this down here. Any significant blueprints or blueprints that we get, of course, like always, I'm going to talk about. And so I'm going to make my little face disappear so I'm not just sitting here awkwardly watching, but I will be watching. If anything happens, we'll discuss it. At the end of the run, I'm going to discuss everything also. What we're hoping is we'd like a global area in HOF. I mean, that's very unlikely. What's more likely and would still help us is a lot of good hits that consistently bring us up over that break-even point. Or just a large stack of explosive projectile recyclers can also do the same thing. And so, honestly, let's cross our fingers. Let's hope for the best outcome we can. I hope you all have an amazing day. And I'm going to get this started. Okay, this is a basic sheet metal blueprint. It actually doesn't have a good value at all. And so, I could probably sell it if I got lucky. But in all honesty, I'm in a trade terminal that. And so, that is what it is. At one point, they were really, really popular. And everybody was doing massive runs of these. And they actually were probably going to sell in some range that was reasonable. But, I don't believe people are still popularly running big runs of the basic sheet metal blueprint. It does go into a lot of things as a component. I already do have one worked up to 100%. And I don't have a disciple on this character currently. And so, you know what I mean? So it will be trade terminal garbage at this point. But the run's not looking horrible. It's just also not looking impressive. And so, actually, it's kind of looking horrible. So let's cross our fingers. Let's hope it pulls up a little bit. Thank you. Hey, how are you doing today? I'm doing good. Very good. I don't know about this run yet. This run is questionably on the border. I mean, that last little 12 PED thing really did help. But it was indicating if it would have kept on its trajectory, we were at least gonna be 30 PED down. And so I'm hoping the new trajectory on this run is more aligned on where it's at right now. That would be a positive run, you know. But you never know. But in the real world, I've been amazing actually, so. But I hope you're all doing good too. Well, that was a global, but not ours. But congratulations to them. That's awesome that they got that. Okay, so we're on the last 50 clicky clickies. And so let's see what happens. I'm gonna be honest, this is really on the border. We're either just a small marginal amount down, or we're break even. And either way, that's not a big deal. Like, but we're talking, if we're down, we're definitely down under 20 PED. I would bet that I'm curious to find out. We only have a few more clicky clicks. Something substantial could happen, but with it being 40 clicks left at this point, let's see. I'll have to check this. Let's see if we got anything. We didn't gain a percent of a percent yet. We did get, obviously, just a slew of skill points and random hits in here. And so, and nothing impressive for blueprints. Of course, we already went over this. At one point, these might have been like a plus 5 PED, sell at auction. I could throw it in there for 1 PED, likely sell it. There's a chance, though, that it doesn't sell. Then you have that auction cost fee gone. I don't want to deal with that. So, I'm probably going to trade terminal that. So, at this point, we've got the trade terminal value of 1 peck on that, which is nothing. We won't even count that in. Like, we only count substantial, significant blueprints, which we didn't receive any. And then we've got this pretty good on strikes. Like, we've got some good hits in there. And so if you look at the overall, see, multiple plus 10 PED strikes. So that's where we're gonna come in to, hey, we likely broke even. We didn't likely come ahead in any capacity. And there's a chance we didn't break even. I mean, like, well, there's a chance we're 10 PED down. And so, let's see. We're down to 70 clicky clickies. Cross fingers. I always thought it would be epic to be like, right as it was rolling in on that last clicky clicky, all of a sudden, like, a global HOF or something. That statistically is unlikely as crap to happen, but what can you do about it, right? Okay. Okay, five more. I lean to we're 10 PED down. Just to be honest, without checking or anything, you know. But we'll see the statistics in a second. Bank. Okay, checking statistics. We're 14 PED down. $14.36, because we're not counting that blueprint. So yeah, that's about the zone I thought we'd be down. Not really shocked. Little bit more than I thought we'd be down, because that looked pretty reasonable as a run. About 90 PED in metal residue is a pretty good indication you're going to break even. And so, at that point, it would have been nicer to have broken even. This guy has a Sith sword of some kind. Well, his sword's cool. Let's check out his other stuff. Oh, adjusted serpent scale is so good. I really like it. This shin guard. Most of that's from his serpent scale. So, here's what I'm going to say. the adjusted serpent scale I'm jealous of. 100%. I have serpent scale plates, and I do think that they're pimp, but man, I'd really like to get them adjusted. Okay, so we're gonna go collect our thing. Obviously, unimpressive run. Wasn't bad, wasn't impressive. Getting some kind of level. Level 27 tool engineer now. So see, that'll be cool when we get that skill. You see what I mean? And so let's see what we got for so we got 2%. So I hope you guys have a just amazing day. Peace, very best wishes, and thanks for watching. I'll see you guys tomorrow.